Shalom, brothers and sisters, Islam Moors. Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. You're now under the sounds of the brother Tazadaq Shah Bey, an aggrieved man, the Aboriginal West Asian. Once again, as you may well know, this is not legal advice. I do not offer legal advice. If you need legal advice, seek yourself competent counsel, if you can find such, and then please be advised. What I'm about to give you is purely for educational, informational, and even entertainment purposes. You know, I've been censored, banned, sabotaged, harassed, all over by, you know, alphabet groups and so on and so forth, but as of now, I'm still standing through the spirit of Yahweh Bahasham Yahweh Shah, still teaching right knowledge. I'm still awakening the people. This is by no means any attempt to overthrow the government or anything of that nature. My attempt is only to educate the people of right knowledge. The information that I'm about to provide you with, if you should find this information of value, kindly click the PayPal link below this video and donate whatever value you may find this information, my time and energy to be worth, be it $200, $100, $50, $20, $10, $5, or even a dollar, whatever value you may find it to be worth. With that being said, what I'm going to teach you today, it's very valuable information. I'm going to teach you about your contempt power, your power to have contempt, because many of you do not realize the power that you have because you don't have right knowledge. See, you have power in the pen of a courtroom judge, of a courtroom black robe. Understand that. Understand that. And after this video, hopefully you will understand that. Power to put people in jail for you if they do not follow the rules and play fair. That means the prosecutor as well. So if you want to win, brothers and sisters, if you want to win for entertainment purposes, your lawsuits, you must know how to use this power to control your opponents and their counsel or their lawyers and attorneys. Most people never stop to think about why we go to court. They assume a judgment or other order of the court is all they need. A piece of paper with some writing on it. They never really consider why we go to court. By itself, however, that piece of paper is worthless. The power of court judgments and orders is the threat of jail time. I'm sure many of you understand that. Power in your hands once you learn how this works. Now, suppose you serve your opponent with a request for production seeking documents relevant to your case, and they respond with objections and excuses or go into acquiescence, which is no response at all. Now, what can you do? Now, as you know, I cannot advise you, but what I would do, step one, file a motion. Now, we don't file motions. As a free man, as a national, we don't file motions unless it's headed under a affidavit. We do everything under the format of an affidavit. Do you understand that? So you file a motion under the format of an affidavit to compel and sit it for a hearing. You got to move the court, folks. So you support your motions with a memorandum, again, under the form of an affidavit, showing why the judge should compel productions. Now, at the hearing, if you follow the example of your brother Tazadaq in this video, procedures, the court will enter an order compelling production, giving the other side a set period of time to respond. Step two, if they do not respond within the set time, set out in the order that you actually set out, you then file a motion in the form of an affidavit to show cause. This motion explains to the court that your opponent fell and refused to obey its order. Disobeying an order is the grounds for contempt. Do you understand? So you set motions for hearing. You got to move the court. See, the problem with many of you, you just filed documents and you let them sit there. You got to move the court. You got to move the court to do something. Black robes don't like people disobeying their orders. You know that. They're very proud people. So the black robe will enter an order given the other side a much shorter time to obey. So step three, if they do not obey the second order, then you file a motion again in the form of an affidavit for contempt. Why do you keep saying affidavit, Tazadaq? Because an unrebutted affidavit stands as the truth. So you file a motion for contempt and sit it for a hearing. Now at the hearing, if your opponent has not yet produced what he or she was ordered to produce, then the black robe will probably have him jail on the spot and kept in jail until the documents are produced. Do you understand? Now, if he isn't jail immediately, then the black robe may give him a few hours to comply. Now, before issuing an arrest warrant, once, I had a Mormon hearing where the black robe ordered my opponent to bring me papers before 4 that particular afternoon or be thrown in the box, jail. So we needed them to prove our case. He brought them. We won. So, brothers and sisters, the goal of every lawsuit is judgment or other court orders that favor your cause. So the power of a black robe's pen to order civilian law enforcement officers to take your opponent into custody if he disobeys the court orders is your power to win. So, with certain knowledge, you can make the system work for you once you know how to play your cards with right knowledge. So, with that being said, I'm going to now show you how keeping or how I have a tendency to keep my opponent honest and show you how to keep your opponents honest. Now, true or false, it's not just about teeth, right? So whether you win or lose in court hangs on those words. What do you do when someone lies on the court record? What do you do when they lie? Do you let it slide by or do you attack? Now, you gotta expect it to happen. Lawyers lie all of the time. People take the stand, place their hands on the Bible, and lie under oath. So expect it to happen. People lie under oath. So whenever it happens, brothers and sisters, and it will happen, I can assure you of that, then you must go on a war path. You must be prepared to pick them apart like Mr. Potato Head. And you must show, because they are a liar, whatever else that they may want to put on the record or have put or placed on the record could also be a lie. So, for example, responses to your request for admissions. So, one of your 5 evidence discovery tools, by the way, are frequently fabrications. So, if the request is actually properly drafted, there can only be 1 or 2 answers. The response is either true or the response is either false. So what do you do when you know for certain that the item you requested them to admit is true, but their answer is a lie? Their answer is false. So you could thank the Heavenly Father that you have pinned them down. Now, if you know how to use your other four discovery tools, now remember, and those of you that don't know, you have five tools to discovery evidence. You have five tools to discover evidence. One being request for admission, two being request for production, three being interrogatories, four being dispositions, and five being subpoenas and other court orders. Now, you can use these tools if you've been watching my channel for a while, which currently teach you how to trap liars in their own web of deception and deceit. Let's say, for example, suppose you serve your opponent with a request to submit or a request to admit he doesn't have any papers signed by you. If he refuses to admit, then you simply serve him with a request for production, asking him to produce the papers signed by you. In a sense, so simple, brothers and sisters, because it simply is. Now, before I bring this video to a close, I want to show you one more method, evident admissibility and discovery. Now, I'm by no wise practicing the legal field. I'm just educating my fellow brother and sisters. Now, don't let the lawyer on the other side throw you a curveball by objecting to your pretrial evidence discoveries request on the grounds that the information you seek will not be admissible at trial. Do you understand? It doesn't have to be admissible. I'm going to say that again. It doesn't have to be admissible. Now, you could actually quote my words, mark my words. Don't let the lawyer trick you into giving up. Many of you often do. They make you offers with threatening language and you give up. Now, if you spend much time fighting lawyers over the facts, you need to win your case sooner or later. They'll object to your discovery request on the grounds that the information you're trying to get is not admissible. And you'll win the court favorable decision if you remember what your brother Tazadaq educates you with. Now, you have five tools to discover evidence before a trial. What are they, Tazadaq? Request for admissions, request for productions, interrogatories, dispositions, subpoenas, and other court evidence. So, pre-trial evidence discovery is not bound by trial rules. I'm going to say that again. Pre-trial evidence discoveries is not bound by trial rules. So once you get to trial, if you don't tune into my channel regularly, you may be all discombobulated and confused. You know, every piece of evidence you try to present to the court must be admissible evidence, or the court will keep it out. Do you understand? So during the pre-trial discovery phase of your case, however, the facts you seek do not have to be admissible, so long as they are reasonably calculated to lead to the discovery of evidence that will be admissible at the trial. Do you understand? So, don't believe me? Go and check it out for yourself. Check your local court rules, and you will find that your brother Tazadaq is telling the truth. You may have to teach the judge. You may have to teach the black robe what's what. But the rules are clear. Many of you allow these black robes to tell you what to do, because you don't know the right thing to do. So you may have to teach the black robe what's what, but the rules are clear. Facts you seek during pretrial discovery do not have to be admissible if they are reasonably calculated to lead to the discovery of the facts that will be admissible evidence when presented to trial. So, thereby, you trap crooked lawyers in their own webs of deception. So you learn the rules and how to use them wisely with right knowledge, and then you win your case. So, with that, I'm going to bring this one to a close. And if you found this information in this video to be of value, then kindly click on the PayPal link below the video and donate whatever value you may find this information to be worth. $200, $100, $20, $50, $10, $5, $1. Or if you are interested in becoming a secured party creditor, you want to be a free man or a free woman, learn how to stand as a man out from under the de facto, then click the email link below this video and someone will contact you as promptly as possible. Or if you need personal coaching over the phone, or if you would like your questions addressed via email, click the email link below the video and someone will be in contact with you as promptly as possible. So until next time, Brother Tazadaq is signing out, and I'm going to say shalom. Thank you all for listening. And if you like the video, take 2 seconds and like the video. Give the video a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel, because this information is imperative to all. But only a selected few will grasp this information because you've been too discombobulated by the powers that be. So I'm giving right knowledge, and I trust that you would actually assist in spreading this knowledge by subscribing to the channel, liking the video, and sharing it with as many people as possible. And since repetition is the father of learning, I encourage you to watch this video at least 10 times. Shalom. Islam.